Ahoj, děti.
Ratafak mi dnes povedal, že sa s nami nudí, že tu nie je žiadna zábava. A tak mu Máša poradila, že ho zoberie na miesto, kde sa určite nudiť nebude.
Tak, a teraz som za divadlom a mal som pravdu. Vchod je aj tu, ale Mášenka nikde. Á, už to mám, čo keď je vnútri, rýchlo dnu.
Puppets have always been an easily understandable, as well as affordable, method of entertaining children. During the 60s up until the late 90s, a large amount of children's broadcasting, especially on public television, consisted mostly of puppet shows. However, given the shoestring budget of many of these shows, some puppets ended up looking more disturbing than others. We've talked at length about creepy puppet shows in the past, but there's one in particular that needs more light shed on it. A show titled Slinyeko, featuring a character named Ratafak Platcha. I've talked about this character before in the top 20 unintentionally disturbing kids characters from around the world video, but there's just so much more to be said about this mysterious character. So today, we're going to be taking a look into the bizarre history of Ratafak Platcha and the show he came from, Slinyeko. In 2008, this video was uploaded to YouTube, and it became the first known clip of Ratafak Platcha. At the time, the video went relatively unnoticed by most of the internet, leading the few who did come across it confused as to what this thing could be and who this creepy puppet was. As the years went on, the video was shared more and more, leading to the video being posted in the WTF and creepy subreddits. This brought Ratafak from the obscure underground into the limelight, being shared and talked about at a much more frequent pace than ever before. YouTuber Rainbow talked about this video on her channel, but she didn't have that much information. It's worth noting that Rainbow was commenting on a clip called Angel, which featured Ratafak Platcha, but really had zero connection to the show. It was just a weird internet clip. Furthermore, Phantom Strider also talked about it in his Top 10 Creepiest Kids Characters video, where I was even brought on board to help. But again, he didn't really have that much information, and neither did I. Actually, there's not a whole lot of information on Ratafak. I originally discovered that he was concocted by a Czechoslovakian TV show. According to a post on Reddit, his name translates to nosy blankets. From what I remember, there really was just no info online. Not even a Wikipedia page. All we knew was that it was from a Czechoslovakian kids show. If only it were just an ugly puppet. But no. Things were about to get far, far stranger. So what exactly is Slinyeko, the show where Ratafak originates from? Well, it is an educational children's show from Czechoslovakia that aired from 1979 until 1989, primarily aimed at preschoolers, roughly around the ages of 3 to 8. Despite its online reputation as creepy thanks to Ratafak, it was actually an incredibly beloved show in Slovakia and the Czech Republic to this day. There were very few TV stations at the time, like one or two at most, so basically every Slovak child watched and loved this show. Think of it like how America views Sesame Street. According to some Slovakian translators, the format of the show was typically split into four distinct sections. The first was a segment featuring the titular character Slinyeko, which roughly translates to sunny, or sunshine with gloves.
Veru vám aj trochu závidím. Máte okolo seba toľko vecí, s ktorými sa môžete hrať. Toľko kamarátov. A ja? Oblaky sa so mnou nehrajú, mesiac chodí von iba v noci. Už som stále samo.
At the beginning of each episode, she would introduce the main theme of the episode and would pop up periodically in transitions. The second segment featured Ratafak Platcha himself, whose name means Big Nose Blanket. Ratafak was meant to look very silly and kind of dumb, which could explain why children liked him so much. It was fun interacting with him and seeing him move. His large size allowed the puppeteer to be inside him in the blankets, so that he may walk around and interact with people. This may seem strange or even frightening to us Western viewers, but for those who grew up watching Ratafak, and mostly puppet shows in general, they grew to love this character. I mean, I grew up watching Teletubbies. I'm pretty sure the Slovaks would find this terrifying. Anyways, here's where it gets really interesting. Ratafak was created as a parody of the elderly and politicians. He would often interact with a group of children, who were the focus of the third segment. The children were taught activities, usually by their teacher, and Ratafak would try to emulate what they were being taught, usually failing miserably. He would also purposefully state false information in an attempt to mislead the audience, to which he would be corrected by the children or the teacher.
My čakáme velkou návštěvu, přijde k nám Pujo Boxer a ukáže mi nějaké finty. Tak, tak, tu máš.
Ráča, takhle, aby si nebyl překvapený, víš?
Jej, veď to je Havo. A přivědal si so sebou tětu. Těta, těta, ty jsi boxer?
Nie, Ráča, fakt těta nie je boxer, to je těta Sáša. A přivědla ti ukázat svojho psa, boxera.
So in this clip, Ratafak believes an actual boxer is coming, but instead it's, well, a boxer dog. And the final segment would simply feature more hand puppets. It seems like your standard puppet show. Well, except that Slinyeko was actually one of the instigators of the Velvet Revolution, which ultimately ended communist rule in Czechoslovakia in 1990. Remember, the show ended in 1989, dividing the country into the Czech Republic and Slovakia. While the show influenced it indirectly, it definitely had an effect. It aired during the age of communism, and utilized Ratafak as a way to teach children to break free of the hive mind and to question things more often. Remember that he would try to mislead the audience and the children. As such, the showrunners were criticized by state censors, but despite that, the show still remained immensely popular. No, Ratafak did not single-handedly defeat communism or anything like that, but this character did become sort of like an icon. He even boycotted the Olympics. Krásný úděl máte dnes. Kráčet k zítřku, žít a kvést. And apparently he was also involved in the 2009 presidential elections.
Ratafak Plachta, váš prezident. Tok nových, silných myšlienok, nezvratnosť histórie, sila koreňov. Byť spoločne v hre.
Interestingly enough, the clip that made Ratafak go viral on YouTube and Reddit isn't actually from the show at all. That is clearly not Ratafak's voice, and the puppeteering is more amateur and crude than in the actual show. From what I understand, the song that Ratafak is singing originates from this clip of TV host Mariana Durianova, who sang When You Got It, Flaunt It, from the musical The Producers.
When you got it, flaunt it, step right up and strut your stuff. People tell you modesty's a virtue. But in the theater, modesty can hurt you.
Okay, so if this isn't from the show, then where did this clip come from? After the show ended in 1989, many of the puppets were simply thrown out, only to be recovered later on, except for Ratafak. The infamous clip of him singing and dancing around, the one that was used on my and many other YouTubers' videos, were made by whoever came into its possession. Other signs that this was not from the original show are the gloves, which Ratafak does not wear in the original series, and his wrinkled neck, indicating that someone with shorter arms was puppeting him. As for how many episodes are missing, well, there is a bit of confusion involved there too. Some sources, both from American and Slovak websites, claim there's over 100 episodes, but according to one of my Slovakian translators, that seems like too little. The program had a new episode every Sunday to encourage children to stay in front of the television instead of going to church. Again, communism. If there are 53 Sundays in 1 year, that would mean the program only lasted about 2 years, which isn't the case. Or that there were simply 2 years worth of new episodes for this incredibly popular children's show that lasted for 10 years. It's possible that there are hundreds and hundreds of missing episodes. VCRs were incredibly rare in Czechoslovakia at the time, and cassettes were reportedly pretty expensive, and were used only to record movies. A show called Slinjako was around from September 2011 to March 2013, and my translator says it's supposed to be the same show, but it looks nothing like it. The series had a repeated airing in 2012, leading to several episodes being uploaded onto YouTube. But the remainder of the series is unfortunately missing. No DVD or VHS compilations of the series were ever released, and it seems like Slovak Television, the current owners of the show, have zero interest in doing anything with the show. You know, after researching this character a bit, watching a few translated episodes, and talking to some Slovaks who really did love this show, I came to actually like Ratafak. He meant a lot to so many people growing up, and I really did enjoy watching him sing and act silly. His design is definitely strange, and he'll probably always exist in that weird side of YouTube. But for me personally, and maybe some of you watching, he's alright. So this one's for you, Big Nose Blanket. Who knows where you'll show up next? Hopefully we can set aside this creepy mystery of a character to rest.
Súhlasíte, že sa stal víťazom? Počuli ste, koľko toho Ratafak vie o psíkovi? Yeah. To my o žiadnom zvieratku nevieme, takže Ratafak, nech sa páči. Skoro ušiel.
Mášenka, deti, vy ste mi urobili takú radosť. Vy ste mi darovali kamaráta.